Today, Kevin and I are going to be trying the handcrafted apple cobbler from the Great American Cobbler Company. This has a sweet, buttery crumble, it says, made with real butter and pure cane sugar. This is frozen. We bought this at Walmart for $6.98. So I'm going to show you what it looks like out of the box. There we go. It says, the directions. It says, remove frozen cobbler from box and remove plastic film from cobbler. Do not remove cobbler from original pan. Center frozen cobbler on a cookie sheet lined with aluminum foil and place in preheated oven. Bake at 350 degrees for 55 to 65 minutes until deep golden brown. Let stand for 15 minutes. Ovens vary. Adjust cooking times as needed. So, we're going to take this, the plastic wrap off, but we're going to leave it in its original pan. Which,
can't imagine taking it out.
No, we're going to leave it in this original pan, which is the bottom pan. And I do have a cookie sheet lined with aluminum foil here. So I'm going to set my timer for 1 hour for 60 minutes, and then we'll be back. So I left this in for an hour, right at an hour, and it's been sitting out for about 20 minutes because you're supposed to let it sit for at least 15 minutes for it to cool off. It might have even, honestly, it's probably set for more like half an hour, but I'm just going to scoop some out. Want to definitely make sure I get some of that crusty part because that's the part that Kevin and I like, but you can see it did not run over at all. On our tray here, so that's good. But you can see also it has nice slices of apple in there. So there you go. So if you think the Great American Cobbler sounds familiar, it's because Kevin and I did another review on their cobblers. We actually found them at Save-A-Lot, and we had never heard of them before, and we bought it and we thought, oh my gosh, this is absolutely delicious. They should be selling these in every store. So when we saw those cobblers that we tried plus this one, it's like, oh, it's a no-brainer to try this one too, because the other ones were so good. So these are manufactured by Great American Cobbler Company in Homerville, Georgia. And it says 8 servings, 1/8 of the cobbler is 270 calories. Great American Cobbler Company is family and farmer owned. We're committed to bringing you the finest handcrafted foods using the highest quality American grown fruits and other ingredients. So, here we go.
I like the topping, the sound of it, the texture, the feel of it.
The feel. Wanted to make sure I got me some apple in there. Mm-hmm.
The base is or at least that one bite I got, is a thicker, like, base in the bottom. Almost has the texture of, like, oatmeal.
I do like the flavor of it. It has a nice cinnamon flavor.
I wonder if that has oats in it. I'm getting an oaty kind of flavor. Like that top part?
Mm-hmm. It has apples, sugar, enriched wheat flour, water, butter.
So it's just flour.
Salt. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The edges are thicker than the middle part. So the edges are really thick. And it's almost thick like you're eating like an oatmeal. It has an oatmeal-like texture to it.
Mm-hmm.
To me, it's not bad. I'm just conveying what I'm tasting and feeling.
My favorite parts are when you get that crunchy outer edge with the apple.
Mm-hmm. It's really, really good. I love the flavors. I like the textures. Just make sure when you do it, you're getting a really good crisp top, because if you underdo it, it's going to be mushy. Just leave it in there long enough to get nice and brown, and you'll be all set.
Because
that's the best part, is the crispy parts.
I agree. So some of mine pieces are a little mushier than others. Yeah. They're softer.
And I guess that's why it kind of reminds me of oatmeal when you get the really thick
I think
parts.
So. I think that's what's reminding you of that. Mm-hmm. But the flavor is, it's terrific. I would just leave it for the a whole amount of time. Mm-hmm. It didn't like even get near, you saw the color of it. It's not like it was going to burn or scorch mm-hmm. or anything like that. It's not like when you're baking a pie and you have to worry about that outer edge and maybe cover it up okay. so that the center can cook.
Because the center will be pale and the outside will be black.
Right. Didn't really have to worry about mm-hmm. this. And honestly, we could have left it in longer than what we did.
Probably. But I think it's fine the way it is.
Yes.
Just know it's not all crispy. It's mostly crispy. Just there's a few spots here and there that aren't.
Yes. Yes. Exactly. So,
I don't mind.
As far as the apple, it's a nice, sweet apple. The cinnamon isn't overpowering. Mm-hmm. It's just a really nice flavor. The difference between this and like a pie... With a pie, you would get like a flaky pastry crust. And this, you're not getting that. Wow. You're getting the crumble on top. So for those of you who don't want that crust, this would be perfect
yeah.
for you.
Yeah, I think it's really good.
Yeah. So I hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching.